Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another Metroid 2 Remake. I'm your host, Alex, also known as Solanus Dracone. Many folks may wonder, why are we doing this again? Because I am going... What?
I know I'm wondering.
I'm doing this so that I can get a sub-2-hour hard mode going. I did a little bit of practicing, I managed to get it done with 1 hour 57, and that was with some small mistakes and dicking around. And with me, as usual, is Rambler81. Hello, Rambler.
Good day. Let's see you pull off this rather fascinating feat.
Yeah, he's a little bit baffled as to why he's involved in today's episode.
And well, because you miss me.
Exactly. So, alright, let's get started. Hard mode, go. Not even sticking around for any of the shit. This is gonna be go time. As such, I may not be speaking much. There will be sections where I'll be trying my damnedest to concentrate. So I'm doing a little trick that the speedrunners tend to use, which is morph balling. When I discovered that I could single button morph ball, then, you know, that helped things considerably because you can go a bit faster.
And of course, the enemy still slows you down.
Yeah, exactly. However, nice little shortcuts like this help.
Huh, never seen that before.
And that's a common thing that occurs. And whenever possible, I will be dropping into morph ball mode just because it does move a touch faster than the standard run. This is gonna be going fast and furious, my friends. It's gonna be a mile a minute. Shortcuts, shortcuts, yada yada, shortcuts. Okay. The enemies are a little bit beefier in hard mode. Also, with hard mode, whenever you gain a missile tank, then you only get 2 missiles out of it. Likewise with super missiles, you only get 1 out of that. And the same deal for the power bomb. So it's considerably less forgiving. You have to do a lot more with a lot less. Enemies hit harder, they take a few more shots. It's gonna be fun.
Yes, fun.
I'm gonna be trying some strats here. To be honest, the biggest problems are gonna be the alphas and omegas because just they're unpredictable patterns. So, bam. Okay, that one got done.
I believe you had mentioned before that none of the Metroids at this point actually drop any power-ups when they're defeated in hard mode.
Exactly. That's another problem with hard mode, is that the Metroids do not drop any recharge power-up things. The only enemies that do that now are, of course, the standard enemies, and, of course, some of the mini-bosses. So, if you have to charge up in between battles, then there may be some runs back to a save point occurring. I will try to most efficiently route that, but a lot of the times I will have to skip a save point check-in, just because I expect certain things to be refilled, like when I get to a missile container, it refills my current stock of missiles. After doing a little boss optimization, so to speak, I'm going to be taking a very unorthodox approach to the Torizo. And that is going to be very fun. It's going to include a somewhat slowing me down kind of thing. And granted, I am not trying to say I am speedrunning this game, okay? That is not what I am trying to do. I am not that awesome. But what I am trying to do is just get a simple sub-2-hour time on this game, which means I'll be skipping a lot of things. There's certain missiles, tanks I won't be getting, just certain power-ups I'll be skipping, things that I can do to save time, unlike this. Yeah, that right there. Fucking hell. Say nothing.
I didn't say anything yet. Yet.
Yet. And also, I'm gonna probably be using a few more missiles on standard enemy moves like this, because that's another small change in the game. The enemies like these little sailboat, manta ray, jellyfish things, they will actually seek and destroy. They are, they're kind of relentless. Things get a lot harder in this game.
I do remember this game, the enemies being very heavy, like beam sponges, so...
Yeah.
I imagine they're much worse in hard mode.
Yeah, 4 shots for the standard little mooks even this early in the game is pretty much, and you might not have noticed it, but those frogs at the beginning, those frog enemies, they actually will spit acid at you. That's something they did not do in normal mode or in any other mode. But spending as much time as possible in morph ball mode is a good idea. And also, you just want to try and maximize just getting as many things as you can early on, because your biggest problem starting the game is going to be missiles. You're not going to have enough missiles to do a damn thing. So just try and keep those rolling.
These are still much more plentiful than they were in previous Metroids.
I suppose. Just you're really going to be in a bit of a pickle for ammunition in this game early on. Which is why I've optimized certain things, you know, just certain boss fights. I've managed to kind of, conserve the amount of missiles that I'm being used. There are ways to make things go a lot faster here. You can do things like, you know, wall jumps and bomb jumps, and bomb jumps are something I've never been good at, so unfortunately I'm going to be doing a little bit of spider bowling here. Spider bowling is a bit slow, unfortunately, but it gets the job done.
Kind of your only option in most cases.
Yeah, it really is. I'm never going to be any good at bomb jumping, so I'm not even going to try to use that. And my biggest, you know, spider bowl usage thing that I had used was I timed it and checked both methods. You know, doing the bomb jump took about as much time as doing the spider bowl, so it's really no point in twiddling my thumbs over it. There are a few spots that I can save some time, and that's what I plan to do.
Yeah, I do recall seeing in the trailer at one point there was some sort of like charge bomb jump where essentially it sends all the bombs in a vertical direction and essentially set up a bomb jump for you automatically.
Well, the charge bomb drop is a thing that I've already displayed in this. You just charge the beam and then drop your bombs, but it's not very practical for much here. Alright, just trying to get as many missiles as possible. I'm gonna need them all. The first boss, I guarantee you, I'm gonna run out of missiles on. There's just no going around it. Now, a lot of folks might try to skip this part that I'm going for to get the next energy tank instead of two missile tanks, but I'm going on the side of caution here. My goal is not, again, it's not to do a speed run. I'm not trying to do a speed run per se. Just somehow maybe save a little bit of time for folks who are having trouble. And, you know, let them see some tricks that I use to get this game done in the sub-2-hour mark. It's plenty fucking easy in normal mode to do it, which is, you know, most of the runs that I'm seeing out there for 100%, you know, normal mode speed runs, those are happening. I've seen quite a few actual hard mode ones, but many of them just tend to use the same old tricks. Oh yeah, wait, I'm going back here. That's right. One missile is enough. What's that?
This thing, I have noticed quite a few shortcuts that I didn't even notice the first time through, so...
Yep. Now, here's a controversial decision that I need to make. Am I going to be going for the missile that's hanging on the ceiling above that big room there? Because that is a bit of a time sink. But it would be an extra two missiles when I could use them. What do you think?
Go for it.
Alright, well, yeah, it's a time sink, but I think I did it the first time through. And I'll do it again. Again, I'm not going to bother with bomb jumping. I'm not very good at it. I'd waste more time trying to get good at it. So I'm just going to try and make my way through the game as best as possible. Well, that was dispatched cleanly. So here's the slight time sink. I guess it wastes about 1 minute overall. Just about 1 minute, but it is useful to have an extra two bomb tanks, or sorry, an extra two missiles. So I guess I'll go ahead and do it. Yep. Never did quite figure out what these enemies are supposed to be. I always looked at them as being like little devils with their arms crossed.
I don't know if I can really see that. I just see them as just kind of like little bat cyclops creatures. Well, I guess not cyclops, but...
Yeah, little weird critters. So I've got everything I came for in this room. It's still in morph ball mode, so that I'm quick enough to get past these guys with no problem. Zoom on out. Again, morph ball mode is really a big time saver. Cuts probably a good 5 minutes overall off the time, but when you're coming in at 157, that 5 minutes makes a difference.
So, Metro, I imagine that, so we get that special picture at the end of the game after we beat it, obviously, and you probably get different pictures based on your percentiles and times.
Exactly.
What is the cutoff for the timed ending, I suppose? Is it 2 hours or three?
It is 2 hours. That you do not get the Samus lounging in her bloomers with the Metroid picture unless you have come in under 2 hours. So certain things are just going to be thrown to the wind, like how much damage I'm taking from environmental disasters, I'm not too worried about. Like these plants that are on the ground, if it gets me in a better position to attack these little bastards, I'm all for it. Perfect.
Well, at least they'll knock you around or essentially do any sort of pushing damage.
Yeah, you actually do take less damage from these vines, and even from lava you take less damage than you do getting a direct hit from a Metroid, so don't be scared to sacrifice a little bit of health on the plant matter here.
I still find amusing how games would depict plant life as being able to damage mechanical objects. Look at you, Blaster Master.
Yeah. Well, shit, thorny spikes, that sort of thing. Plus also, since the Metroids leech energy, then certainly the plant life on this planet could leech energy. Oi, I'm talking to you. When they start to dodge is when it gets really a big pain in the ass. Now, I've seen some people trying to incite the dodge by just trying to shoot a regular shot at them, and that'll work. That'll make them dodge, and you won't waste a missile out of it. But, you know, it's a bit fiddly, and especially when my hands get cold, my joints get a little bit, you know, sore, unable to respond to that sort of thing. So, yeah. Anyways, this boss that's coming up, this one is a tough one on hard mode, especially because of the limited amount of firepower that you have. So, you know, Rambler is going to help me explain a little bit about how the enemy works, but basically you just watch the color of the eyes. So, you know, pretty much blue eyes, he's going to fire straight down, so just move slightly out of the way. Green, he's going to fire like that. Purple, he's going to do that, so duck. And, yeah, so when it's green, get right under him. When it's orange, jump up. Please remember to hit.
You have a lot of missiles, sir.
Yeah, the end of this battle is going to be pretty much nothing but this stuff. But just get used to the color of the eyes. When it's green, get beneath him. When it's purple, duck. When it's blue, get a little bit to the side. And when it's orange, then just try to jump as soon as the ball hits the ground. Please note, as the walls get closer, he's gonna stop doing stuff like the orange shit. Yep. For quite a few bosses, you will have to depend upon just actually using your shots there. And that's going to be a strategy that I use on Arachnus when I get back to him. You know, you only get so many missiles for him, and it's not always enough.
I actually find it interesting they make the being a viable option against bosses in this game.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you very well speak up.
I was saying that it's interesting that they make the being a viable option against bosses in this game is all.
Well, you know, they do kind of note that you are going to be getting your ass handed to you a little bit. So here's a small little shortcut that can be used to jump under there. Kill these things as best as possible, they will follow you. Like that. See, they watch exactly for where you're going to land. I'm going to be picking up missile containers when and if they're convenient. But I'm not going to be going out of my way to go back. So don't expect all that vacuum tubing backtracking shit that's gonna occur on some games. I am not trying to do 100%. This isn't any percent run. So just checking my time, about 12 minutes and 5 seconds for beating that boss. Could be done sooner, but I feel like that's a pretty good time for this point in the game.
What is the one missile block up there that could have destroyed? But I don't really know how much time that would really save.
Honestly, unless you're dropping straight down, it is not saving dick all for time. Now, the secret missile room on the right, you kind of need the high jump boots for that, so not even going in there. Now, of course, this is the surprise Metroid room. Not much to worry about, really. Press the attack. Yeah, you can tell I've gotten a little bit better since the last time I played.
Don't get frightened by that one anymore?
Well, I kind of expect it now. Alright, this is also a little bit of a controversial decision right here to go up the tower spider ball style, but I just find it, you know, more reliable, really, than trying to do any other method. Now, yep, missed him. And now we're about to take on Arachnus. And I've worked out a fairly decent strategy for Arachnus. You are going to run out of missiles on him fairly quickly, so gotta prioritize. During the first stage, he's going to be shooting that slow, bouncy fireball that, you know, goes across the room. Then the second stage, he's going to be firing it faster. Then the third is the green thing, and you want that one over as fast as possible. So for the first two phases, I'm just going to go ahead and burn him up with regular old shots. As soon as you hear your shots tinking off of him, then you know that it's time to give up. Give him a second to roll into that. I've died a couple times to this guy. Oh boy.
Here he goes.
Bait the bomb stuff. Oh god, I cannot survive much more of that. Alright, that's the orange flames. A little bit easier to dodge than some of the other stuff that he's gonna be doing. Oh boy, that's a bit close for comfort. Oh god, don't be that close. Nobody's comfortable with that. Okay, now it's time to unload, and this is gonna be really tough. I may die against him. Yep, I just died against him.
Oops.
Yep, so that's why you gotta get better at that. Thankfully, saving and going into your map and all that transitional stuff doesn't count against your game time. We knew this sort of thing was gonna happen. It took me a couple tries before I got that guy beat, but I still hold that the starting out with blasting him with your blazer bomb, or, you know, I'm not talking about it. Starting out by blasting him with your regular beam shot is the way to go. And maybe start running a little bit later in his spin cycle there. Because what seemed to be bothering me was that he was getting too damn close. Alright. Round two, motherfucker. I'll go ahead and start dropping bombs on him. Missile. Be careful with the timing of your missiles. Oh, shit. That's new. Alright. Yeah, that shit is... That persists. Alright, unload time. I want to get him out of this phase as quickly as possible. Fuck! Yeah, that's the rough one.
Third time's charm?
Oh yeah, we're sure. And you may be wondering, well, why do this now? Why not go for some of the other power-ups? Because the spring ball's gonna help me out with some of my future stuff. So it's a matter of doing that. I could go for the Varia suit, I could go for a lot of things, but I don't want to have to double back more than I absolutely have to. I'd like to avoid that shit, if I could.
Of course, I guess it helps we're aiming for 2 hours in-game time rather than actual time.
Yeah, this is not going to be a 2-hour video. It also helps if you time the bombs better. Each progressive one sends him a little bit higher. That almost hit me. That hit me. Oh, I'm in shit right now. That is a dangerous attack right there. Fuck.
Oops.
Not going as well as I thought. That's why it might be better to hold off on fighting this guy until you've gotten a few more power-ups there. The Varia suit would be very helpful. The wave beam would be pretty helpful, as well as what other extras you get. But I've done this before, so just it's about execution. I'm gonna shut up and concentrate now. Or could you not? I would greatly appreciate it if you would not. Oh god. This fight may be over. Yeah, I do not see this working out very well. God! Finger fuck up! Cold joints! Okay, that's a hell of a strategy. Just duck for that shit. Alright, just learned something new about that particular stage. Duck. Sweet. Awesome.
How See, dare you figure out my weakness trying four times!
So yeah, ducking for that green thing can be helpful. It just keeps you in a good spot there. And now I have a way to speed my thing up here just a bit. So yay! Alright, pretty sure that I'd need the high jump boots to get up to that particular challenge, so... Oh god, this guy's getting smart. Quit being smart. There we go. Onward. Okay, gonna be going for the wave beam next. Gonna have to learn to deal with always skip leg day bot there. Hate that guy. That's another rough patch of this particular thing is those the bots that fill up the area, they can be pretty tough.
Plus it's a bit irritating too, really.
Yep. Of course you can learn how to duck under them. Or do this shit. Yeah. Yeah, Mr. Piccolo would be proud of me.
I still consider you a nerd.
Nerd!
What?
Awesome. Alright, high jump boots gotten. Are you over here, you little cunt? Don't forget going over here. This is worth getting an extra E-tank at this stage in the game. Don't be afraid to burn up a few power bombs, actually, simply because you will pretty much be not. Sorry, don't be afraid to burn up a few missiles because each tank will restore you to full.
That's actually kind of interesting. I never realized they actually filled up your missiles for each tank.
Yeah, and you can plan out your routes that way.
Probably is meant to be an intentional saving grace.
Well, you know, they have to think of the speedrunners. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Okay. Don't forget doing this. Hate these fuckers. Hate that guy. That's why the wave beam is a good thing. Pew 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 pew. Just take a few hits, it's okay. High jump boots really actually help this out quite a bit. And only one thing down here, just another missile tank, so I don't need to hang around in this room very long at all. Now, I'm okay with wall jumps. So that right there is a decent enough little cheese for me. This one, just tank the hits. Alright. Okay. I'm not looking to shave seconds off, just, you know, looking to get the game done in a reasonable time. Whoop, 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 whoop. And up I go. Whee! Next stop. Well, probably now is a good time to go up and try to take on that Metroid in that other room there.
That is the one up here now.
Yep. Now's a good time for that. It's not gonna waste too much time, and it's a fairly, fairly safe room. Not too many spikes going on. Oh my god. Oh, oh. Stop, stop. Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Oh dear, how much time would we lose here?
Well, here's the question. Not too much. A little bit.
It's not a question, really, it's more of an answer.
Bite me. Come on, come on, come on. Do, 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 do. Alright, fine, so we need to play a little bit more safely. There was a save point right beneath me. I should have gone for that. Stop that shit. Ugh. That's another problem. These little Metroid babies, they get really, really in there, you know? Didn't have to jump into him, though. Could have avoided doing that. Alright, this is gonna be a little bit problematic now. Don't shoot me back out with always skip leg bay bot. Oh, the randomness of this is killing me. Let's try this again, see if we can't go for better. It's gonna be really close. I lost a little bit more life to that Metroid than before. And by that I mean fuck tons. Ow. Wow.
Oh dear.
Yep, things are getting dire. One hit from these guys. That's all it's gonna take. But, thankfully... Oh, maybe not so thankfully.
Yeah.
Aha!
Oh, if it works, right?
Yep, if it works, it ain't stupid. Alright, E-Tank makes us alive again. Whee! Okay. Things won't be so bad. That was an embarrassing death to the Alpha. You. Go in a timing in a manner that I can actually work with. Thank you. Your patience is appreciated as we go through this transitional period. And maybe I should just go ahead and take care of this lot of fuckers right here. It's a couple extra seconds, but it means I take a little bit less damage on my way back out. Well, maybe not. Yeah, a little bit less damage on my way, and the point is I don't get a lot of chances to regenerate my health in this area here.
Perhaps be a little more careful and judicious about the hits that you tank?
Yeah, sometimes you gotta skip it, sometimes you gotta actually kill it. Alright, I think we'll be just fine. There we go. There. Take a moment to hoover that all up. Alright, skillfully done. If I do say so myself.
Well, you did.
Yep. Except this time, I'm gonna be a little bit less devil may care about things, and I'm actually gonna go ahead and drop a save. So, let me go ahead and get my way back up to Arachnus's room area there. Yes, it's a few extra seconds, but it's worth it, and save time doesn't count against your game time. So let's see, we're at 18 minutes having defeated Arachnus and gotten all this stuff. I think so far we're okay. Although, fuck. Yeah, that's the sort of thing that costs you a couple seconds. It's minutes I'm worried about. Sometimes you also just gotta be aggressive with these little fuckers. Get over here, you little fuck nugget. Thank you. Bam. Alright, next order of business. Oh, shit. Yeah, you see how these things follow you? Little fucker followed me a little bit. So here's what I'm gonna save.
Death All by right. Pancake is a bit humbling.
Yep. Usually that happens in hard form. Now, you don't have to use missiles on this. You can actually use bombs, but I find that's not worth it. Two missiles takes care of these little turbines. Okay. Try not to get hit as much as possible. And just to let you know is that while you're running, when you switch into Morph Ball mode, it seems to go a little bit quicker. You hit your full speed faster. Now time for us to fight this little fuck nugget. Come on. Come on. Come here, you overblown magicite. Come on. See them hanging around at that fucking altitude? Doing his dodges and shit. Stop.
Trying to survive the encounter. How dare he?
Yeah, exactly. Worth grabbing this. And we go the uppity-ups. There's really no point in killing these guys here, because they're just going to be here outside the room again. But it's time to get the Varia suit, get a little bit more survivability. Just shoot it out right there, that saves us a few seconds. And ye old masterly effect. Okay. Oi. There we go. Little secret up here. Worth going for. Drop in here. Try to drop the bomb right about there. Go through the ride again. And get missile. Every little bit of extra missile we can get in a timely fashion is worth it here. Especially when we get to dealing with the gammas. Alright. I think we're on a good heading now. We're just going to be heading into the area with the final three Metroids plus the first gamma. Just our time check. We're at 21 minutes. Like to be done with this area before the 30 mark, if possible. Okay, quick save. I may be coming back to this save point, by the way, because missiles are going to be at a premium here. What were you saying? Were you saying something?
Oh, okay, I was actually expecting the next zone to come up here, but no, this one is significantly less complex to deal with.
Doop. Okay, got rid of that guy without too much loss. And I don't think I'll go back to the save point here. I've got enough missiles to handle the next Metroid, so I'll probably head back to save point after killing this one. Then, with the save point check back, which is going to save me, you know, a little bit of headache, that is going to allow me to have plenty of missiles to take on the Gamma. Get the fuck out of my house. This is my safe zone. Go away. Oh dear.
Oh, he's not having any of this.
No, this is a spry little fucker. Ow. Woo! Alright. Now's probably a good time to go for this.
Yeah, I was about to ask if you're gonna get that or not.
Yeah, I'll get it.
Plus, you still have to go back for your missiles.
Yep, I'm still going to go back and recharge my missiles, but that doesn't help. But after that little bit of nonsense, you know, it's good to just check back in, because what if we have to do all that shit again? Alright. I think we'll be in a good spot. 23, I think we'll be okay to finish this area in under 30. I'd like to do it less than that, but, you know, we don't always get what we like.
So you can't always get what you want?
Yeah. Now, interesting point is that the Gamma Metroid will appear after you kill this baby. It doesn't matter which order you take them all in. The Gamma Metroid will still be there. This is potentially a favorable spot, because it kind of keeps him above you and at a good angle. But not always. I do have to wonder about the hitboxes on these guys. He leaned forward and I had a shot at his soft underbelly. Quit it. Quit it! I can't be wasting missiles on the likes of you. Alright, he's dead. I heard him. Now this is gonna be a fun one, but I got a little trick for this fight. Got a little trick for it. You get down on top of this pipe, and you just crouch. You are in a decent position to spam the missiles into his belly. So yeah.
I suppose this one doesn't have the trick of grabbing you?
It might, but he didn't make use of it. So that was cleared in under 25, not bad. Back to morph ball mode. And the next area is where we take on. So far, so good. Ow. Quick actions, baby. Fuck. Alright. And another save, why not? We don't know when's the next time we're gonna die. Ow. You do slow down for a second when you bounce in this ball, but overall it still saves you time. And no, I'm not going to be going for the missile tank up there. It's going to take way too long. Remember, only if it's convenient to the run. If it's not too far off the beaten path. We may be more or less at the point where we don't have to worry so much about our ammo, but well, that's always going to be a concern, but there are ways to manage your ammo in the coming areas. Don't think I've forgotten about the breeding grounds area. Alright. Okay, these things can get annoying. Another missile tank over here. Again, it only takes a half second or two to grab that, and it adds just a little bit more safety onto the run. I'm playing a marathon safety version of this here. Okay, now this, we're about to get into a spot where I'll be doing a somewhat of a controversial decision, but I feel it is worth it, is that I am going to be pretty much spider-balling across the top of the room in order to avoid going to Torizo until I have a few more things in my grasp. Because the Torizo battle, let's think of how many times I died against Arachnus and multiply that. That's how many times I would die against Torizo if I didn't prepare. So I'm going to be coming back at him when I've got a few more goodies, a few more toys. So,
of course, yep. It's very easy to explore that lore area without getting the space jump either, so...
Yep. I mean, the idea here is that I want to get that right side of the area completely taken care of before anything else. And also, this date comes on a shameful date because I read on the AM2R website, unfortunately, Milton Guasti is not going to continue developing this game. He got the full DMCA dropped upon him from Nintenderp, and they're just not doing it anymore. No more updates will come out for AM2R, so 1.1 is final version.
Well, then again, I thought it was kind of cheeky that he actually went on to finish 1.1.
Yep. By the way, when you see this particular pillar, that's about the safe point to drop off. And now, having to fight the Torizo to get to this area, then I can focus on getting a few other toys. And yes, it is completely doable without the space jump. There are ways and ways and ways to get shit done here.
Like I did the first time.
Yeah. I may even teach you a thing or two, actually.
Of course, that last room's a bit of a pain in the arse, but I think that is what safety saves are for.
Yep. Okay. Spazer. That alone makes the Torizo fight much more manageable. Just because the way that he shoots out those projectiles, you don't have enough time to knock their asses aside. Probably shouldn't be mixing it up with these little fucking Kit Kats either. But now I've got more HP to support my habits. This is a fun one, although it can be eminently manageable. Eminently manageable if you stay in this sort of a position. Now, interestingly enough, when they're right on top of you, pointing down with your missile can help. But I think I'll just stick to the old crouch method. God, I am just losing all sense of anything right now. My fingers are just practically numb. So I'm hoping to make up a little bit of energy on these random little enemies here. Just enough to survive it. Okay. Now let's see if I can manage this other time-saving maneuver here. This is gonna be tricky. Basically, I'm just running through the entire big rooms here. And... Woo, did it!
Nice work.
Yep, that got dead. Alright, I do want to get the missile there. So go to said rock, grab, and be done.
Curtis is going to put an identification marker on the floor there for you.
Yeah, they rarely do that. Alright, that's
sometimes
doable.
Sometimes they do. Like, I don't know if you ever played... Well, okay. For the viewers out there, if you played Super Metroid, the one Meridian missile tank that you have to essentially jump from... or space jump from the very bottom of the level to, like, halfway upwards. There actually is, like, a little brush that you can find on the ground that marks where you're supposed to jump from to make that work.
Yeah, it's a bit tricky though. It's pretty spot perfect, so you gotta be careful about that. No, you don't, you little fuckface. Nope. Fuck nugget with legs. Boom. Alright, energy tank. Now everything is viable again. And this one, it's perfectly okay to go through this room all helter skelter. Spider ball across that.
Oh, well, would have been a little bit easier than my method the first time, just to do a space jump all over again.
Yep. Well, you're going to love how I handle the Gamma Metroid and the Lava Pit around this area. Alright, there's no point in trying to build up a space jump here. But we're going to make one try only at a very, very tricky jump, and that was the try. I was going to try and build up a space jump so that I could go up there. You know, I'll give it one more go. Well, that's my plans thwarted. Thwart my plans? Yes. Alright, this is a dangerous, dangerous, dangerous spot. I fucking hate these diagonal bots.
Yeah, this is when the whole beam sponges thing really came into play here for me.
Yep. Now, if you hang back enough, it will they will go diagonally up. So here's how I deal with this shit.
Yeah, just eat it.
Yep. Just face tank the lava. It's
or
not all that bad,
corrosive
really.
Liquid, whatever they call it.
I'm also gonna let this guy come down to me because lava hurts them. Alright, and I'm fairly able to handle this guy, so.
Of course, I don't suppose the water affects him at all.
Doesn't have a damn effect on him at all. But he seems reluctant to come down and actually make use of his appendages.
I wonder if that was an intentional effect, or is this simply how the room was laid out?
I don't know. But generally you can make it through this little section without losing too much health. Maybe a quarter of a bar. This next spot's gonna be tricky though, because if I absorb any damage, if I get any damage taken from these guys... Alright, that was better. Now the way I find this one better to handle is bouncy, bouncy, bouncy ball. Ow. Ow.
Worst game of mousetrap ever.
Yeah. This is also fun right here. I hate this. Is time being counted here? Let's see. 33:44. 33:44. 33. Yes, time is being counted. That's pretty dick. Now, these guys are actually pretty harmless when they are up, so you don't have to worry about that. And you can throw the super missile just a certain distance. Maybe ill-advised. Nope, that's fine.
So you can go 3 for 3?
I shouldn't have a problem with the next section. Ah. I'll let these things slam down once more. And then I can make a clean jump.
Punch and scoop.
What's that?
Punch and scoop.
Yep.
Yeah. No.
Yep.
You ever watch Harvey Birdman?
Nope.
No?
I've caught snippets of it, but not enough to say that I'm familiar with it. And we got Super Missile. Now, interestingly enough, this little pipe right here does nothing until you burn a Super Missile. Then you got birds coming out of it. And they will stop coming the instant that you get a power bomb off of them. Oh, sorry, a Super Missile off of them.
See? Heavy orbits, yeah.
They're done. Things are still gonna be pretty hairy, but I should be able... Ooh, good thing I stopped when I did. Things are still gonna be pretty hairy here. And this isn't nearly as dangerous the second time. Alright. Whoop! Oh, okay. Good enough, good enough. Alright, speed boost. Yeah, that didn't go as perfectly as I had planned, but it'll do. I really do want these guys to be dead. These diagonal bots. Alright, this is gonna help my chances greatly. Perfect.
I have a feeling things are gonna go south very quickly.
Now we'll be good. We made it through the most dangerous parts. Yep, the dangerous parts are done. Smooth sail from here on out. If I could get my freaking jump to work. God, the spacer just makes such short work of these guys. And let's see if I can do the super speed. No, I'm just gonna play it safe here. And by that I mean I'm just gonna disregard all logic. Should be able to build up enough speed? Yes.
Gonna get the bonus? Oh, there you go.
Yes. Alright, getting up out of here. Daunting for some, but I got my corner jump all sorted out.
Who do you think you are? Some sort of, Megaman X?
I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
He bolt jumps and such.
He's a fighting robot. Mega Man! Alright, this may be challenging. Nope, did it. And this also provides a much better save point for going at Teresa. But since I'm in this direction here, might as well go down here and take care of this stuff. There's one more Metroid in this direction.
And other essentials.
Yeah, just a few small, little goodies here. This part, it's just best to get it done. Run on through. And then we've got this Gamma. Oh, well, they're with my chances at dropping a super missile. If you can get even one super missile into these guys, it makes a huge difference in the survivability of the fight. And as you can see, I'm not terribly worried about ammo or, you know, taking hits here. Because I can go back to that save point. Alright, listen, fucker. Don't have time for your shit. Alright, another run through. Maybe a good idea to fire when you're going forward. Alright, gonna drop off and do another save in this room here. And then we should be just fine against Teresa. And our time is at the 39-minute mark, so if we can get rid of Teresa before 45, which I think is eminently doable, then we should be okay. Okay. Tis the time. This is gonna make things so much easier. I'm firing at him rapidly to find out when his weak spot opens up, because I'm gonna be firing a good couple missiles into him. Now, there's actually a semi-safe point right about here, while he's flinging that shit, so you can survive him doing those, little thingy things. Alright, part one taken care of. Still have most of my health, and I'm just gonna try to light him up as much as possible. Super missiles help against this guy as well.
Five more hits you don't have to do otherwise.
Yep. Also, bear in mind, as you can see, the spacer is really helping out with that shit. Alright, he's pissed. Doing the crossovers.
I call this my Neom attack!
Yep. This is also a very good opportunity to do a little bit of damage against him. Alright. That's a good sign. We're antagonizing him into doing crazy shit a lot quicker. Alright, he's damn near dead. Yep!
Woo! So is that sand that he's puking out, or do you think it's actually tar?
God only knows. Could be sand, but I don't like to think about it too much. But, as you can see, the Torizo fight was so much more manageable when I had the spacer and some super missiles to drop into him, so I think that little detour that I took was worth it. Alright. And we got it done well before the 45-minute mark.
Did it well, you say?
I say well before the 45-minute mark, definitely. Okay. This has nothing to do with the Doritos Tacos thing, by the way.
Yeah, well, you finally realized what I was going for.
Oh, I knew from the get-go. I just wanted an awkward silence for a moment. Alright. Sunk one super missile into his ass. That's gonna make the rest... Well, it's always that. Alright. So I'd say that's worth going back and saving real quick for. I think, don't get ambitious, don't try to sink more than one super missile into these guys. Oh, come on. I thought that guy up there was hard-coded to do that shit. There was a little dealy-bob up there that normally they're hard-coded to give you a super missile, I thought. Unfortunately, another problem you face in this general area is that the, little spiky bobs that you normally would use to recharge, they don't give you dick.
They just get in your ways and your good obstacle wood.
Oh my god, he got in.
Yeah, I was wondering about that part of your plan.
Oh.
Oh.
Haha. Okay then.
He came into your house.
That's right. Okay. Do I dare? Yeah, I think I'll dare. There's an alpha and a gamma up here. Should be able to manage it without too much muss or fuss.
In theory.
See, what was the sweet spot there? Can you feel the tension?
Not terribly, but then again, I'm not a controller.
Whoop, whoop, whoop. No, you don't. Come on. I dare you. I double dog dare you. Wee. Woo! Alright, no way I'm surviving fighting any more of these as I am, though, so I need to try and hold out for a couple of super missiles.
Oh, come on!
Don't even, sir. This'll turn into a sub 3, and that is not what I'm going for. Alright, I got one super missile, that's all I wanted from that room. I just want to go up and save. Now is an okay time to save because we haven't gotten too deep in there yet. We're not losing too much time. And see, now he gives me a fucking super. We're not losing too much time by coming back here, but it is going to save us a lot of headache.
At least you get your super missiles refilled at save points anyways.
Yes, that is true. And we're about to add another super missile into our cannon as we go through, so it's going to be fine. Of course, I would have to land on one of those assholes. Okay, this is a fun room. Whoop, 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 whoop. Alright, I got one in him. That is enough. That justifies everything. I don't care what you do to me. I'm still gonna win. Though, possibly by a slim margin. They really have gotten more aggressive. Stay the fuck still! Wow. I'm half wondering about going back and recharging. No, I think I'll chance it. Alright. Chance to stock up in this room here. Make sure you shoot out all the little spiky bobs. And you do want to have one super missile tank at least. Because you need to do that out. And you need to do that to get rid of those. And you need to get rid of those so you can do this. Okay, drop down. Oh, come on. I normally get a little bit more lift than that. Let's try that again. There we go. So that is a third super missile. A fine thing indeed.
A bit of a devious puzzle for this kind of area, though.
I don't know, not that bad.
Just the darkness and all that, though.
True, but, I mean, if you realize the signs, you know, if you see what you're normally looking for, then it's not going to be that bad. I don't know how I'm going to survive that, this next one, to be honest. Try to take out the spiky balls before you even get close to them. You don't want to regret not doing that. And just for safety's sake, I'm even going to take those out. Alright. Ooh boy. Oh my god, I just blew all my missiles on him. All the super missiles, and I'm dead. Damn. Alright, let's try it again. I may cut out some of that shit, but no. Let everybody see my miserable failures. We're at 45 minutes game time. Boy, I sure hope there's not a game time penalty for dying.
That would be kind of vicious, wouldn't it?
That would be a bitch. Alright, I did take those guys on, so this is fine. God. The Gammas, I don't know, they feel a little unfair to me. Such a tiny, tiny little spot to hit them in, and they're always constantly in motion. I have to say Gammas and Alphas are definitely my least favorite Metroids. Such tiny little hitboxes. Alright, I actually survived that with more HP than I thought, so I might be okay to go ahead and try again on this one. Just need to get a super missile block from one of these little guys. Come on, super missile. Thank you. Don't forget to get rid of the daily bobs. Woo! There we go. And I am somehow much better equipped now to deal with that next fight. I don't know how I lost all that health. Can you tell me how I lost all that health?
Couldn't say.
Must have been in the first time I fought that Gamma, but my god, man.
Well, get good.
Yeah, it's... If it were just a matter of skill, I'd be okay with it, but a lot of this is luck. If they decide that they're gonna do a weird pattern, then it's all over, you know? If the Gammas decide that they're gonna do a weird pattern, there's not much you can do about it. Alright. Okay, I summoned the super missile in him. Ah, yes! Woo! Two
that
supers,
went exceptionally
baby.
Well.
That was much better. And a quicker way up. The little things we do to save time. I'll go ahead and keep my charge beam going here just in case I go ahead and frag one of these guys. Doesn't hurt to have a little bit of extra. Okay. That really went better than I could have expected. Definitely better than the first time. Okay. We are just below 50 minute mark, and we're already done with the bulk of the Gamma Metroids. At least the tough ones that we won't be in a great position for. It's actually a bit faster to return to go up this way.
Well, personally, this is probably my least favorite area. It felt the most tedious, at least.
Yeah, I don't think it was 100% balanced perfectly, to be honest. This general area there, I mean, if you're playing normal mode, it's fine, you can just manage, but it's a little bit unfair for hard mode. So much of it depends on luck, and if X were different, if Y were different, you know, if ifs and buts were candy and nuts, we'd all have a Merry Christmas. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
Alright. Things get a little bit easier from here on out. Just a little bit, and then I say that, and then these fucking flying pancakes, who do not die on one hit, no matter what you wish they would do.
You could always use super missiles on them. Just saying you could.
I could, yeah. But I'd rather save the super missiles for a little bit more intense of a fight. Like the one I'm about to have.
Sure you don't want to talk about some rappers first?
Eat me. There we go. I feel no guilt about that. And we will be back, worry not.
You go back for the stuff here?
What?
Talking about going out the elevator once you get the super bombs, or what?
Yeah, that's what I plan to do. That's another one of my little controversial decisions that I've made.
Well, that is going to be a mutual time sink.
That being said, it's also going to save a little bit of time on a very difficult boss otherwise.
Fair enough.
There's places that I can cut down the use. Now, 7 super missiles will take down an Omega. See, that's what my whole super missile planning is all about. 7 will take down an Omega. But you know what else will take down an Omega? 6 regular missile. I'm sorry, 6 super missiles and 1 regular.
Speaking of super missiles?
Yeah. Actually, it's 2 regular. 6 super, 2 regular. So if I decide to go for just the 6 max super missiles, I'll still be okay. Glass breaking. Very satisfying sound, actually, the breaking of that green stuff.
I find it very interesting how they found interesting ways to gate you from progress until you get the proper items, whereas the previous game, it always just relied on you not trying to burn yourself through the lava, essentially, not having gates otherwise.
Pretty much. I think Guasti, you know, Dr. Mario, or whatever the hell his name was, Dr. M64, he planned for this sort of thing, like, do whatever you want in the game. But I wish he was still developing it. I wish that he had, you know, if we had a 1.2 with maybe a little bit fairer Metroids.
Although the Game Boy original game does actually get into the final area with an actual, like, indestructible block until you get all the other Metroids first, if I recall. But even if you have, like, an invincibility cheat, you'd still have to essentially destroy all the Metroids anyways. Not much to say here.
I was on mute.
Yes, you were.
Alright, so I'm gonna go for a couple of decent time savers here. Time and frustration savers, really. Get out from under me, you bubble. Okay. This one don't seem to care so much about the lava. But it worked. It's nice that you were given enough time to do that, you know?
I'm pretty sure it was fairly intentional on the designer's part.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm glad that they gave you enough space to do that. Boy, it would be too much to ask for that Metroids are bothered by extreme heat. Come on. Look at what a little dick this guy is being.
And it's an alpha to boot.
Do you mean to bout? Or what are you... Are you trying to speak Canadian at me?
To boot. You don't see... Yeah, I do make fun of your Texan accent every now and again, but still.
I don't recall you doing that.
I need to do it more often then.
Challenge accepted.
You and your 20 health.
20 health isn't a problem anymore. 20 health I can deal with at this point. I'm okay with 20 health. Alright, another bit of a time-saving skip up ahead. It's past where the tunnelers are. That wasn't it. That wasn't it. That's not it either. But I'm sure doing a lot of that, aren't I? Alright, here it comes. Should be fine right here. Come on. Right, and go. And keep running. There you go. Look at how much time that saves you. Are you not impressed?
Yes, I'm very impressed. I forgot I was on mute.
Yes. I hate these guys. Screw it. I'll just eat it. I'll just face tank it. Not gonna bother with this. Don't have time to bother with that. I think I've got enough ammo to the point that I'm not overly worried about being able to fight any more Metroids. That being said, AD is pretty pathetic. I'm sure I'll be fine.
You'll find some way to make us a cold, hard winner?
Yeah. Bitch. Okay. We're getting into the red zone. Now let's see if I can pull this off. Nope. Nope. Not worth it.
I just love seeing those things get frozen and just fall to the ground.
Can't happen here, though. Ow! Ow! Stop it! Being mean. That part was cool, though.
Yeah. Maybe really the missiles will work there, but it kind of makes sense.
Yeah, you don't think about it much.
Yeah, well, I don't know. The Metroid series does kind of play fast and loose with some of their ballistics.
Now, you would think that, you know, because it says percussive force is required against these guys, you would think that your bombs would do something against these little guys, these Metroids. But it don't.
No, you have to make their membrane more solidified with the ice beam, I suppose, which would make kind of sense, right?
Well, I'm talking about the mature Metroids.
Like these guys.
Yeah. Alright, so this guy, I'm gonna pull a tiny little trick. Pull a tiny trick. Exit the room and come back. And that just leaves him open for a super missile. These guys are a lot worse about dodging super missiles. You gotta hit them at certain moments of vulnerability, like right after they hop, or right after they spray some acid. But as before, every super missile that you can drop into these guys is gonna make a difference. Alright, it's all regular missiles now. Face them down. Only takes a few more. Ow. Woo! Good times, huh?
Yeah, what is your time right now, anyways?
58:21.
Not bad.
Yeah. I'm gonna need to make a stop in at the pit stop here. Which is gonna eat up a few seconds. It's gonna eat up probably about a minute. But I don't like my chances against an Omega right... Or, I'm sorry, a Gamma right now. With that little health. Although that Gamma is fairly... slightly easy to cheese. I'm gonna be going for all the Metroids in the area before I make the journey into the tower. There's a lot I'm gonna be doing before the journey into the tower.
And for good reason.
Yep. Alright, I'm happy with that many shots. Beautiful. Nice clean kill, I would say.
Much quicker than the earlier attempts, mind.
Well, it does depend a lot on the layout of the room. Alright, next Zeta. There was no point to doing that. Alright, let's see if I can do what I meant to do beforehand, which is just get a little bit of a sneak up on him. Come on, hop! Hop, fucker! No, don't... Oh boy, this fight got more complicated. Oh remember, every extra missile, super missile that you're able to drop into these things is that much less trouble. It makes the fight immensely less complicated. Every missile is worth a good, you know, five regular missiles. Every super missile. But I'm still going strong. That was a nice little shortcut there. Saves a few seconds. So far, time is 1 hour and 38 minutes. I'm sorry, 1 hour 38 seconds, excuse me. Alright, fairly simple Metroid fights here. These are not terribly challenging. Having extra super missiles makes a huge difference. Here, I'm going for as much bottom space as possible. Go ahead, zap. Boom. That's right. That was an easy one.
And you kicked over his sandcastle. I hope you're proud of yourself.
I sure am.
Gonna go for that E-Tank?
Yeah. I think it's worth it. At this point in the game, yeah, the E-Tanks are worth it. Now this missile, I don't know if it's worth it, but hey.
Well, you're in the area.
Yeah, I suppose. Alright. Problem is, we got these, got those crumble blocks to worry about.
That was almost where you're just gonna bomb on the blocks and just ignore it afterwards.
Yeah, that would've been shitty. I actually did a pretty good retrieval on that one. My retrieval on that one was okay. That one wasn't so okay. Damn it. Well, this shenanigans isn't helping me. Okay. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and slide down the side of the tower here. Gonna hit my save point up. Recharge. And I think I'll go take on the Zeta before I take on that other Gamma. Cause if I run out of missiles on the Zeta, big fucking deal, you know? That's what I'm supposed to be doing, is I'm supposed to be pumping super missiles into the Zeta. The Gamma, on the other hand, I can just do regular missiles and survive, although that one's a touch more challenging. This room is also a touch more challenging. But, if I play my cards right... Alright, I could sink all four super missiles into him. This fight just got a little bit less troublesome.
Of course the train makes him prone to jumping anyway, so it gives you more open shots.
That was a nice triple right there. It also helps that his little rush is, you know, kind of hampered by the spike pits. Oh god, no.
Oh dear.
No. That shit ain't gonna happen.
You're not gonna die to toenail clippings?
No. The Naglfar will not claim me this journey. Whoop! Bye. Alright. Take care of the Zeta. I'm at 1 hour and 3 minutes, not doing bad. Wish we had a timer up that, you know, we could more easily check.
Of course, how reliable would that be, though, since, you know, it's not counting game time anyways?
That's true. Unless he paused it. But then you gotta reset it, and yeah, it's not worth it.
No. Even the Skype clock now says an hour and a half.
Yep, that's pretty much what my OBS is at. Come on, zap it. If you even get one, Super missile sunk into these gamma guys. It's still worth it. There we go. Woo, clean fight. Not as clean as it could be, but still pretty good.
Acceptable.
Yes. Now, getting the power bomb is going to be fun, because you remember that there's one particular spot where having a power bomb is super helpful, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you only get one. Mm-hmm. So you got to make your way out the normal way. I cannot believe this time is being counted, though. This time should not be counted. This waiting on these fucking doors thing. Okay. Not exactly high pressure here. But I do want to get rid of that little fucker. It's a few extra seconds, but it's worth it. Just, you have no idea how much I hate those things. Yeah, this right here, you have to do this on the way out. Good luck. Rest of it's actually pretty cake, though.
Then again, I think with using a sort of progression bar in place of a standard time allows me to kind of fudge the time bit anyways.
Well, to be honest, though, the time isn't exactly accurate on that progression bar.
Exactly. It's designed to build that tension and to create that little dramatic moment at the end.
If it were a Metroid game where something didn't explode as Samus was trying to leave it, then it just wouldn't be a Metroid game.
Still see it's a wonderful subversion, though.
Yeah. It's just telling you how hot the core's getting. That don't necessarily correspond with time.
I understand, when we get back to the room, I'll talk about it, but there is a way to fall through the floor in there and actually get through quicker, slightly.
Yep, there's also a way to jet back up the tunnel here. If you can get the timing exactly perfect, then you can use the speed boost on your way out to get back up the tunnel, but, you know, that's for the pro-ass gamers.
Is that going to include you?
No. Well, maybe. I mean, I'll try at least. I'm not exactly MLG, sir. Oh boy.
You went and done did it.
Of course I did it. It's scripted.
I still don't get how, like, even right now it just looks like a minor increase in the cell temperature, it's already causing all these explosions.
Yeah, it's weird that way. I want to save the super missile, and now I don't have time to regenerate from that guy's droppings. Just the way that wall collapsed in, ain't that something?
Pretty sure going back for supplies doesn't really matter that much in this phase anyways.
Nope. Alright, let's see if I can pull this off. Nope. Not worth trying second time.
Well, I think you'd probably still save a good chunk of time if you try for a second attempt, but oh well.
No, I'm good. We're not talking about a massive change here. I just love killing that particular guy with a smash. He's like, I'm Mr. Badass Triple Turret Fuckface. And you just smash through him. There is a speed boost thing you can do here. I did not think to do it. But things aren't going so bad. Oh wow. That temperature is going up.
Yeah. You'd almost think it was scripted.
You'd almost think. Oh dear. Oh boy. This is the time. Now this time, I don't think I have any time to deal with this fucker. So, I'm just gonna try my very best.
Like the one it was?
What the f- Why do you bring a Pokemon reference? references into this.
Because I'm an asshole.
Ich bin nein Pokemoner. Okay, that went pretty well. But in the end, nothing changed. The future refused to change.
There you go. I just love to think of, if you go back, there is like a little small space that like a morph ball could get into.
Like that.
Samus was shoved through there. Just think about that.
Yeah. She was pushed through a very small hole. Don't forget to go back here, guys, because E-Tank
somehow survived the explosion.
Chozo technology, baby. Oi. Well, that's just fine. Come on. God. Fucking pedantic bullshit. There we go. And then you would think it's onto the tower, but no. Time for a detour. Yeah, I know. I managed to work this in to my sub 2 time, so I feel pretty good about it. Of course, you know, getting a few things here and there doesn't hurt.
What are you doing, sir?
Here's what I'm doing. Oi. I've got a detour to go through.
I guess every missile counts against this next boss.
Oh, there'll be more than that going on. This next boss is enough of a pain in the ass that I want to give myself a little bit of extra insurance.
I suppose it helps against subsequent bosses too.
A little bit. I mean, I don't find myself using power bombs against a lot of bosses. But that's what I'm going for, is I'm gonna do the GFS talk.
Really?
Oh yeah.
Well, aren't you being ambitious?
Well, I manage. I've done it before. And it really, really does help. It really does help to have a few power bombs to drop against the tower boss. Now, what's gonna be fun is fighting Genesis. That's gonna be a hoot and a half. Genesis is very, very damaging. Can I just not take damage from one of those guys? And yes, there is a way to actually speed boost up this shaft here as well. Not happening here.
Well, this seems probably plenty fast already.
Yeah, I mean, this is pretty damn quick. Alright, two things that I gotta accomplish here. Pretty sure, yeah. Alright, so number one.
I still love they threw this reference back in here, though.
Yeah, it is a pretty cool little thing. And then race across. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Yeah.
Again, just kind of speaks to like the love and devotion of how much they are fans of the game to include details in there.
Exactly. It's just a nice addition. So now I have 3 power bombs to my name, and I'll have a 4th one when I go back to the tower and open up that little spot that was to the left of it. And I'm gonna only use 3 of the power bombs against him because I want to have one open for a super missile tank that I plan to get. So you know, three power bombs is going to make a big difference against this upcoming boss. Not Genesis, but you know. Because I am concerned enough about Genesis being a pain in the ass, I'm gonna save. Because, boy howdy, Genesis is a pain in the ass.
And what if you go against Phil Collins?
You have time. I just don't like them. I think the Cyndi Lauper version of True Colors was better. You would think this would work, but no. That Tor has got your beat. Alright. Okay, nope, none of that. Just don't get hit by the claws, that's the major thing.
I still feel bad that can't replace us in any other existing Metroid lore, though.
It feels like from Metroid Fusion, the dudes that were in the room before they turned into the Golden Space Pirates.
Right.
Do you know what I'm talking about? The little fuckers that would drip acid on you from above?
Right, right.
That's what these are.
Huh. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, somebody, one of my commenters on Reddit brought that to my attention. Alright, fuck this. Guess what hurts this guy, too?
Really? Well, it finally makes sense, because I think, again, we've kind of talked before about how Super Bombs seem to be mostly utilitarian rather than weaponized in these games, really.
You'll notice I am in some dire straits here.
Woohoohoo! Life charge from this.
Definitely a lot more terrible than he was in Metroid Fusion. Pretty glad that he didn't actually get out to fuck with you in Metroid Fusion. That would have been rough. Alright, so a minute and 14, no, hour and... We're at about an hour and 15 on this. So I think we can make it. Trying to remember what my time was when I did it on the solo run. There were certain spots that I just, you know, I fucked up. I could have optimized better. Oh god. Nope. God. See how bad it is in hard mode. Mr. Mute Key.
I just don't have a whole lot to say.
Alright, so, geared up with a couple extra power bombs, an extra E-tank, then I should be pretty well off against that boss. Fuck!
Oh.
God damn it!
Oh,
curse my hubris. Oh boy.
At least you saved here.
Yeah. Hello darkness, my old friend. That'll teach me to do hubris. Again, guys, this is, you know, I'm not pro. But I did a thing, I want to do it again. You know, I wanted to see if I could damage him with that. Nope. Ow, ow, ow. Ugh, it's the claws that really fuck you up. Oh, fucking... Ow, ow, ow. Ow, ow.
You have to wonder where this extra power and aggression comes from, though.
Well, they did have them in tubes. We do know how the Galactic Federation fucks around. Alright. Let's try to salvage this shit.
It seems kind of interesting, like, well, I guess it's kind of a thing of space fiction in general. It seems like if there's any sort of galactic organization, they're never always on the straight and narrow.
Well, I mean, it's just standard, I don't trust government stuff. P- people don't realize how conservative they're being, because it's very popular to say, oh, the government is corrupt and they are fucking with the citizens and trying to consolidate their power and all that. It's like, you know, it's a very, very popular thing to say and do, and it's, I don't know, I think it's sort of the poor man's plot line. I think Final Fantasy did enough of that for us, you know? Ooh, terrible government, and only a small group of rebels can actually overcome them.
Well, really, when you have a kingdom called Baron...
What's wrong with Baron? Baron's a good name for a kingdom.
I don't know, I always kind of associate like a baron with someone who's like pretty ruthless and seizing power and such. Much like a dictator. Are you gonna die again?
Nope.
No.
I wasn't planning on it. Ooh. Should face tank a little bit less of these guys. Might be a bad habit of mine.
They are kind of irritating, like in terms of placement always stopping you like this.
Yep, and just you can't avoid them even if your morph ball is clearly smaller than their path. Now at this point I could just skip the plasma beam altogether if I wanted to, but I went through a lot of trouble to get it. I want that plasma beam.
And there is a super tank or two to be had here anyways, or super missile.
Yeah, exactly. One. Exactly one. Alright. So, I want to be able to conserve at least one power bomb for after the fight, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop a bomb up there. That'll
and
hit...
Somehow it reaches down there.
Yep, it'll hit the yellow door up above, it'll hit the bomb barrier there, I get my missile recharge, and actually a handy-dandy little shortcut entrance into this area.
Huh, never realized that.
Yep. It's one of the many benefits of, you know, straining your shit.
Sequence breaking.
I don't think I've broken any sequences.
Yeah, I guess not, but... You're not going through this whole mystery of, ooh, what's the purpose of this tower?
Yeah, I'm not exactly hitting the TLDR stuff here. Alright. That puts us right at the boss. Now, power bomb here is going to help in a couple of ways. Number one, it's going to damage the his shields there, as you can see. But also, if he happens to be firing anything, it'll actually destroy all of his little gun turrets. So, demonstrate. Well. Yep, see? Boom. Go ahead, turn again. Alright, so that's all the power bombs I'm willing to use against this boss. That is not all the super missiles I'm willing to use against him, though. Probably be trying to get in a couple hits on him, what shouldn't I?
Yeah, well, that would speak a little bit, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, mobility's sake.
I think he does quite a number on his hands, though.
Boom, baby. I should be fine. Oh, time to take that shit out. Alright, you have no defenses, bitch. See how much easier it makes that fight? Okay, I'll be honest, it didn't make it incredibly easier, but... It helps.
Yeah. And super missile now, again.
Yep. Extra super missile. And plasma beam. Which actually, upon reflection, the plasma beam is not all that awesome. I mean, it cuts through these guys, but this is kind of the last time you fight armored enemies like this. So I do wonder what a game without the plasma beam looks like. Do you honestly need it, you know?
Yeah, well, I would wonder if there's something down the road that requires the plasma beam anyways.
I'm trying to think of it. I mean, it's going through enemies is what plasma beam does.
Well, I mean, we're talking about using power-ups to gate progress in this game, and here you have the wall that had to throw the power bomb.
Right. But again, I'm trying to think of some place that the plasma beam actually makes a damn difference. So our time is 1 hour 19. And we are well on our way to the water area. I'm not going to be dallying as much here. Not going to be going after the tunnels. Again, I'm only interested in getting my super missile tanks up to 6. 6 should be plenty. Now these little guys right here. See, this is what confuses me about these little buggers is what the hell makes them so tough? You know, I mean, we were fighting these up in like dry ass lava granite zones and they were just scuttling along the ground. How are they so powerful now?
Perhaps their biology is much more favored in a liquid environment such as this.
I suppose.
Perhaps the pressure on the being underwater helps condense their skin and armor shells?
I have no idea.
Just taking a rough guess, my biology is not exactly the strongest.
I'm distressed at the amount of time I'm wasting against these fuckers. I should waste less time against these fuckers. Alright.
Now it's time to blow some mines.
It's not so bad. Oh, you lied to me, sheep. I got you like pig. No, I got you like sheep, that's right. Bitch!
Not sure what you're going on, bro.
Could have planned that a little bit better, okay. Shut up.
Jump straight to the middle of this bullet hell. What could possibly go wrong?
Okay, so I should take a moment and wait for these things to disperse. This shit. Alright, let's see if I can be a little bit more sensible about this. Oh dear. Sensibility is gone. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Woo! Okay. That was fine. Everything went fine there. We have nothing to worry about. And now another cool little trick I'm going to try to pull off to save some time.
And the space balls!
Woohoo! Oh, we're the space balls! And we're gonna take your air!
Oh boy.
I'm not coming back for that. Just letting you know, I'm not coming back for that particular missile.
No.
That is a super missile, there is no easy way, no good way to come back for that.
And now this bullshit.
Did that on purpose.
Refresh memory, who played Lone Star in Spaceballs anyways?
How the fuck should I know?
I don't know, because I don't recall him being in anything else.
Was he Captain Mal?
No.
I don't fucking know from goddamn these guys.
Not like John Candy or...
Oh yeah, John Candy. If you don't know John Candy, then fuck you.
Of course, then again, no. What kids nowadays really know who John Candy is? Because they'll be
No, they would have no idea. Nobody would know John Candy. And that distresses me. Almost as much as this shit distresses me. Go ahead and spit your spit. Oh dear.
Oh no.
Oh dear. Oh no, 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 no. He's spitting the stuff.
This is not going according to plan.
I can still survive.
I'm helping!
I brought a ball! Because everybody needs a ball! Whoop, whoop, whoop. Nice choice of what to do there. I approve. Go on. Keep your rounds. Keep on doing your circuits. Oh yeah, that's even better. There we go.
Woo!
That was a bit tight.
Nah, dude, I got like 6 whole health back.
I guess that's true.
But it's still worth going over here and recharging. Where are we at? Hour and 24. We got like 35 minutes to finish this game, man.
Think you can do it?
I don't know at this point. I'm gonna try my damnedest. But remember, all I need is 6 super missiles. That's all I technically need, is 6 of them. Oh yeah, let's just start that fucking war.
Gonna blow some mines. In theory.
I just as soon not have to deal with that. I'm gonna be honest, we might not make it. This attempt might be no more than an attempt.
Still gonna post it?
Don't know. Really? You fuckers survived that shit. Where'd the ball even go? Seriously, where the fuck is the ball? You little... Fuck, did you get all the way over there? Oh, the balls. So hard to predict.
I think I'll just complain once again. It's not like she has hands that she can use to pick this thing up, huh?
Yeah, exactly. Or like the grapple beam in a previous game, which technically is the future. Shut up, time is hard.
Oops.
Yeah, that's it's get the fuck out time. That's cool.
I didn't realize they didn't damage you on contact, though.
Nope. And now they are completely negligible. Whee! That's
just
fun.
Cut through all that shit.
Yeah, how do you like that shit, motherfuckers?
This is your I don't give a fuck attack.
Exactly. It's the screw it attack.
It doesn't screw you.
Yeah! Fuck them all. Now, unfortunately, I've got something I have to do in this general vicinity.
Get the best weapon in the game?
Nope.
Oh. Yeah. These guys. Kind of a shame the screw attack doesn't do anything to these guys, though.
Yeah, I know, right? Now, you don't have to finish this entire battle in one go. But it doesn't hurt if you do. Might need to be a little bit more sparing with the missiles, though. Nope, I'm good. Yeah, I managed. Battered and broken, but I managed.
I sometimes wonder, like, is it kind of the cheekiness of having you fight, like, 8 Met Alphas at the same time? Or is it like, we have no place to put the remaining quota of Metroids in this level.
Pretty much. I'm also wondering exactly how I'm going to deal with what's coming up. This is going to be, it's going to be interesting. Oh yeah. This part.
We'll be fine. As long as you remember the, rules. Solutions, at least.
Of course I remember the solutions.
Oh, look at you.
Know what else I would learn? That.
Oh, well. I still have to wonder how this field necessarily is negated by the gravity suit, though.
Stuff. Purposes. Reasons. It's Chozo technology. It doesn't have to make sense. How the fuck can one woman roll into a tiny little ball like that?
Well, apparently, according to game theory, it's not that difficult.
Fucking... stop bringing up MatPat.
Just saying.
Don't... no. You're fucking parroting MatPat. Tired of that shit. MatPat is not the final authority on every fucking thing, okay? And besides, he uses the "it's just a theory," which completely discredits what a theory actually is. I'm not saying I
is
don't
it,
like MatPat.
Because it is based on, you know, empirical evidence as much as anything else, right?
Okay. You don't say it's just a theory. You say it's just a hypothesis. Saying just a theory is like saying, you know, fucking breathing is just a suggestion. Theory is something that is incredibly proven to the point that it is accepted as fact. A hypothesis is, I have a guess. An educated guess, but I'd like to be certain about it, so I must get it supported with evidence. We're at 129. Not too bad, actually. Just gotta take out two gammas here. And
wait, bottom.
Which is fine, I can do that. Just gotta exit the area. Ooh, that is the luckiest steal. Fuck. This is perhaps the worst. Come on, just stay right there. Yes. Woo! That went better than usual.
There you go.
That's gonna trim like 10 minutes off my fucking time.
Blub blub means I'm back, bitches!
Yeah. You guys wanna try some shit now? I'm trying to remember exactly how much of this area is optional. Because I am desperately needing to get back some time here.
Gotta love they made those into speed blocks.
Yeah, it's just kind of a fuck you move. Alright, I'm gonna take a moment to sit and think here. What is optional? Is this optional? I'm pretty sure this is optional. No, I'll go down. This is definitely optional. Okay, so this up here then is the actual progress bit. Trying to remember what was in this room. I guess I'm just gonna go look and see for myself. No,
congratulations.
This is the way to a fucking missile.
I was just about to say, congratulations, just found a missile. There you go.
Alright. Now, Saris, I figured him out. He's not that bad. I figured out Saris.
You don't know me!
I'm gonna kill you. Saris, you freeze this shit and then you shoot the shit with bombs, or with missiles or whatever, and that breaks it. Then he's completely vulnerable to percussive attacks. And regular attacks, too. So really, it's just about that. The freezing thing is just about knocking off his protective shell and then just go to town, wail on him. That's right, Saris, you ain't nothing.
You talking shit to me?
Yeah, I am. Do your fucking water ballet.
I'll pee with all over your ass!
Come on. For the first part of the battle, I'm just gonna use regular missiles and freezy bombs.
Hey man, that ain't cool!
Someone trying to cram a Swiss cake roll into this DVD! Sorry, I guess I'm not Bubs. I need to stop fucking around.
Chasing your prey.
No, I don't feel safe about that.
Are you supposed to miss them yet?
Yeah, it's about time. Come on. Bring that shit to me, man. Bring that shit to me, man. Come on. Fuck your shit. Alright. Might want to freeze him a little bit more. Yeah, this fight's taking longer than it needs to. Getting close though. Moving pretty fast right now. Yep, he's dead.
At least he takes damage from the next game too though.
Yep. Now before I go face those two. Before I go face those two fuckers, let me just make a pit stop here. 34, we're cutting it close, but as I've said, I've gained some time back by not dicking around with some of the extra stuff. I swear I hit one of you guys twice. Cut that shit out. Alright, enough of your cockamamie bullshit. Thank you. Okay. I believe that SR388 stomach has the rumblies. 1 hour and 35. Gonna get close.
The rumblies that only dead Metroids can satisfy?
Yep. Metroid hands. Where are you taking me?
Or tendrils.
Yeah. Or claws.
Probably most accurate.
Yep. Alright, so we are leaving behind. We're leaving behind a super missile upgrade as well as a health tank upgrade. What you see is pretty much what there's going to be. All that's left are the Alpha and Omega, and well, pretty much the end of the game. So, can I do it?
So if you gotta make the most out of this, you really only have one shot against each of the Omegas coming up, don't you?
Pretty much.
It's technically four.
Yeah, but I'm not worried about them. The Omegas I can fucking deal with. Those are no problem.
Alright, let's see your boss strategy then.
I've uploaded that, sir. You didn't watch it, did you?
Buy more reference to this video.
Well, there's not really much left. There's the Alpha, and then there's the Omegas, and then there's the Queen. And then that's it, we're done.
24 minutes.
I think we can do it. Well, if this shit stops happening.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah. A couple quick shortcuts there. One thing that they don't have a shortcut for, which really kind of pisses me off, is the waterfalls area. What the fuck did you do?
Moving my legs and I hit my desk.
God damn it, dude. Can you stop being such a disaster zone? Thought you fell over and fucking hit your head and shit, dude. That's how violent that sounded. No fair that those little guys can just run over those fucking spots. Boy, so far I am doing a lousy job of reining in the cussing, aren't I?
Yeah, so let's see how that affects you two, but I don't know.
Nobody has seemed to care before.
I do have to wonder what brought this all along though. It's now that advertisers want to be more specific about who they want to advertise for, essentially.
Yeah, I've never quite got the entire story on that. I think we're talking about the new YouTube is not going to allow you to monetize certain things. And it's like, they haven't been letting you monetize those certain things, just they never spoke about it. Now they're being clear. So let's see, sexual nudity is not allowed and all that, yada yada, right?
Yeah.
So, Makes sense. I'm gonna do something you're gonna say is stupid.
Waste a super missile? Two of them?
Yeah. And you know why that's not a problem? Because I get them refilled when I get the next tank.
You still didn't kill an alpha.
Well, most of it's missing. But no, when I go and get that super missile tank that's in the room behind the Omega, then that'll make up for it. And now, let's see how things go, because that's going to give me a total of 6 super missiles. If I miss with even one, then not gonna be a fun fight.
Yeah.
But if I do 6, then all I need is 2 regular missiles. I have done this before. So let's see how this goes. Well, it's gonna go poorly for them. And no, I'm not even gonna try hitting them in the back. Yeah. You're very scary and big and large. Alright. Okay. Let's see if my kung fu is strong. Yeah, that shit don't work. Come on. Call me cowards and call me untalented. Alright.
Now what?
Oi. 1. 2.
Oh, look at you.
Yeah, look at me.
Look at me, I'm Mr. Meeseeks! I just beat an Omega Metroid!
That's fine, but we asked you to beat the entire thing underneath 2 hours. You still haven't done that.
Oh, can do!
Because I'm at 1 hour and 40. It's not going to take that long to beat these guys.
Ooh, can do! Come on, Jerry, you gotta follow through!
No?
No.
You don't dig that? Well, you're just Mr. Poopy Butthole.
I'm not gonna do that, either.
They're the same basic voice.
You do those kind of things.
They're the same basic voice. Mr. Poopy Butthole. Why name him that?
Claustrophobic inside of these caves! I can't do that.
Yeah, you really kind of failed at that.
Yeah.
There is one unpredictable thing that can occur with the baby Metroid, which could fuck up my game time.
Oh.
With the baby Metroid, the problem with him is that I've seen him get stuck in a little loop around certain of those, you know, carbohydrate crystals. And if that fucking happens, then that's it. Game over. Alright, and go.
Oh, look at you.
Yeah. Look at me. Look at me not even hitting up the save point.
Oh, then again, you're not really going to get much out of it at this point unless you really screw it up.
Yep. And of course, some folks may be wondering, well, how are you going to recharge super missiles between the mega battles? And I'm all like, what do you think these little daily bobs are for? As long as I don't lose too much life or regular missiles, then I'll be able to resupply 6 missiles pretty damn easy.
You call a lot of things dealy bobs, don't you?
Look, sir, I'm under the gun. I'm under stress here. Yeah, that goes into the tunnel. Okay. Ow. Oh dear. I just wasted one. This is a problem.
I wanna go fix that.
Not much I can do about it at this point. Just have to see. Whoa. Hey, buddy. You were on the right track before. Okay. Hi. Yeah. You're not killing me enough, dude. One, I could probably bury. But 3, nope. Oh. Managed to bury one in his back. That could have been helpful a second ago. Alright, so we knew that was gonna happen.
How far back you gotta go? Oh,
not too bad. No, not all that far. Although, I probably will make a save. This is the risk we run, folks. Again, did I claim at any point that I was trying to be a speedrunner? I think I've specifically said I wasn't. Just you know, making sure I've covered that. I'm not claiming to be pro as fuck either, but I know I can get a sub 2 hour game time on this. I've done it before. You son of a bitch.
Well, that was a little less sloppy than your first time anyways.
Was it?
Slightly.
Well, that was just as clean as before, though. We'll go ahead and save.
If just to save us some time.
Yeah. Although I don't expect those are mistakes that will be repeated. Normally I'm a little bit better on my game, but I normally don't play for this long at a single sitting. One mistake you don't want to make is not having your super missiles selected when you go into this. Because if your first shot is a dinky old regular missile, then, yeah.
This could always take me this time.
Yep. No, the fire does not reach up here. Now I just don't care how many times I miss. Well, actually I should care a little bit because I do have to farm those little dealy bobs, don't I?
Yep. Do you think it'd be faster just to go down to the,
No.
No?
Definitely not.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah. It's called planning, sir. Although I need to go back up. Now let's see if we can win the game of never touching the ground. Yep.
A game with the floor is bubbly acid death?
Kinda is. Yeah, I was trying to get greedy, go for a back shot. Oh, wait. Oh, I landed one!
And you failed another. Oh, well then.
Yeah, back shots do, I think, like either double or triple damage.
At least that would excuse their very short open window.
Yeah. Alright. Got a refill. Alright, that's the six. And if I get any lucky back shots here, then we might save a little bit of extra time. That is a very hard shot to make, by the way. Don't forget, select your super. Yep, that wasn't gonna happen. See if I can manage it this time. Nope. And that's just added a little bit of extra time onto this fight. Maybe if I hit him in the back. Damn it. Oh dear. Oh dear. Still managed. Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Close enough?
Yep. Now I have 15 minutes to finish this shit. I have 15 fucking minutes. Less than 15 minutes. It is not going to be a sub 2, folks, unless something miraculous happens. Unless I am Uber. Okay, it's fucking Morph Ball all the way, baby. Nope, not even worth saving here. I can save when I get to the Metroids. Question here is, can I get at least a speed boost across this room? Yes. But that's it. That's the only speed boost you managed to get.
So it's just a sub-happy then.
Yep, they take great pains. Yeah, I was gonna say, is there a way to jet up through the waterfalls? There is not. Or is there? God damn it, I should have saved before coming up here. Wait a minute. Does this send me back down? No, it doesn't. That didn't do shit. That's something that they could have put in here, you know? They just could have added in just the, hey, how about you, you know, have a way to skip the damn waterfalls. But no. But no, Dr. Elfie's had to design my glamorous form to be inefficient.
Yeah, well, she's not a drinking scientist.
Call that bitch out, huh? Alright, here it is, the home stretch.
Now, is she really all bad if she helped a ghost accomplish his dream?
I helped a ghost accomplish his dream?
Oh, yeah. Hapstick look.
Yeah.
Gave him a body that he always wanted.
Yeah, just, you know, all the horrible Shoggoths. Kind of distract from the good.
Yeah, well, that was separate from that, though.
Anyways. 12 minutes. Well, at least I'm not going to be wasting much time killing these guys. Watch me make a wrong step. Seriously, if I get headshotted by these guys, yeah, that's it, I'm done. I don't see surviving that. That was close as shit, dude. Fucking 10 minutes. I can take it. Alright, time for the queen.
I think you might be able to pull this off.
No more going back and saving. Alright. Hey, baby. You look sexy.
Do they need tricks for this fight?
Nope. Same old, just handling it a little bit more efficiently is all.
Make sure you don't want to save up until you have a full missile health stock.
Eat me, you cunt sucking fuck face. See, this is why I can't hold to my resolution of not cussing. This guy is still involved. Yes,
hey,
I know
you
I invited you.
Me.
I know, but you don't have to strain my resolve. First stage is always tough. There we go. I have died to her like this before, just letting you know. Face tank a few too many.
I think we're still doing fine.
Yeah. Try not to get too far ahead of her, because she can overcompensate her rush and hit your ass. Stay up there, baby. Should probably jump sooner than that. get hit by every single headbang she does.
You can take it.
Gravity suit is badass.
Oh yeah? I do even take it off. Don't do it!
You sure?
You have better things to do with your time.
That ain't counting against my time. Fucking point set and match, bitch. 8 minutes to get out of the planet. I think I'm good.
Gotta do a quick kill?
Yeah. Ain't even sticking around for it.
Aren't you glad I showed you that?
Yeah. Makes a huge difference in how gory everything is. But now we're on a different kind of clock. We got 7 minutes to make it out. No time for baby to
eat.
No time for baby to eat. Get the fuck up here. Oh god, please don't do the loop-de-loops, baby. That would ruin mommy's day. Get up here and eat your fucking vegetables.
No, I don't wanna! I want the red crystals!
There are no red crystals! Mommy couldn't afford it. That's gonna cost me precious seconds.
I forget, dude. Seconds you get registered on the clock?
These seconds, yeah. Look at that. 1 hour, 53 minutes, 58 seconds. 1 hour. See? They get registered.
I just mean on the end game clock, we can show that part. Okay.
I don't know if the seconds get registered, but I won. This is actually beating my previous time. And that's it. Time. Sub 2, baby.
Woo! So what's the total to save or kill the animals again?
Ha ha ha. Oh, ladies and gentlemen. It may not be impressive. It may not be all that awesome. It may not be 100%. But you know what? It's an accomplishment that I feel I wanted to record. I've been enjoying this game immensely. I've loved this game. I'm so sad that it got taken down. I'm so sad that Milton Guasti is not going to continue working on this, and all the other great people that worked on this. I'm so sad that unfortunately the truth and realities of the market had to come down on us like this. But at the very least, we can say that they got their legacy out there, that this game got released. This game got put out onto the public, and it's out there. You can find it on torrents. You can find it all over the place. It is there. Nintendo can't do a damn thing about it having existed. And you know, I wonder if other people are gonna take up the mantle. What if in the background they're gonna have other people that take this game and do other stuff with it? What do you think?
I don't know. I mean, my wishful thinking would be that somehow they sort of have a Metroid Maker come out of this project, essentially have this engine ready for other people to make their own games with. Because honestly, if you kind of think of it, if you just remove some of the, or change a lot of the assets, you really have a functional game engine here that's like prime and ready for use for that kind of game anyways.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not exactly sure what they used for this, but I do remember, again, as we discussed during the main series, the Blind Play series, that they did switch engines partway through, but this feels pretty faithfully like, I'm not going to say Metroid Zero, because it's a little bit tighter here. It feels a little bit looser, and, you know, loose and tight at the same time. And yes, they do count seconds, by the way, as you can see there.
Oh, there you go.
And our reward picture for beating this, nothing I haven't seen. You still get it for normal mode, sub 2. But if you take easy mode sub 2, you don't get to see Samus kicking back, drinking a heatap on her way to Ceres Station. And let's get our canon ending, shall we?
Yeah, well, I see nothing going wrong here.
The last Metroid is in captivity. The galaxy is at peace.
So, I want to thank anybody for watching who has watched me through my Any% Sub 2 of Hard Mode on Metroid AM2R. This was not intended to be a speedrun. Once again, I must underscore, this was intended to be just sort of showing certain shortcuts, certain alternate options that you can take, that if you take them, you can still manage to come in with an under 2 score. If you want to see some 100% runs, that's great. I'm not going to be doing that. I don't have the patience for that. But hopefully some of the tricks that I've shared here can help some people out, and hopefully somebody at least is sharing with, you know, my accomplishment. I know that Rambler81 is sharing with my accomplishment. Aren't you, Rambler?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Now I want you to beat my time. I dare you.
Nah, I got other games to play.
Sure you do. I want to thank everybody for watching. Once again, my name is Alex, also known as Solanus Dracone. With me, as usual, Rambler81. Goodbye, Rambler.
Good night, everybody.